Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. Now today's video is going to be one on LinkedIn, which I have missed talking about so much, so I'm excited to bring this video to you. Now, a lot of people come to me with the same complaint where they say, Natasha, I'm sending messages on LinkedIn to hundreds of people and no one is responding. Why do people not want to talk to me? And I'm like, well, whoever it is in front of me, I say their name. I'm like, look, show me what you're sending these people. And everybody is falling into the same trap of not being original, which is why I wanted to film this video and just give you a few pointers. Some of them might be pretty obvious, some of them you might be doing already, some of them you should try out, and a lot of it is going to depend on your industry, your niche, your personality, like what type of sense of humor you have. Like, it's all going to be adaptable to the person, but these are the things that I would recommend following that are going to help you out so that people do want to speak to you and they're not getting sick of automated salesy messages that they receive from 10 other people a day and they're just never going to respond to you, probably unfollow you, probably remove you as a connection. So let's start with tip number one, which is don't be salesy. Now, I've said this so many times, but I'm going to say it again because it's so important. Don't go with the intention to sell. Go with the intention to have a conversation with somebody and make a connection. If they're interested and they like you, they'll probably ask you what you do and what services you have. Like, most of the time I know that someone's ready to speak about sales or kind of move the conversation towards a sales point of view when they say, so like, what client success stories do you have, or what services do you offer, or like, how does your company work? And then we'll start talking about it and then I'll be like, oh, I actually like checked out XYZ, like there are a few things that I'd recommend you could change. Do you mind if I send you that information? Like, you ask for their permission before you send it. You don't just send them a pitch. When you've just connected with them, they're like, oh, this person seems nice, nice personalized connection request. Then boom, they're just hit with, buy my product, buy my service, go to this webinar, go to this case study. They don't care. They don't want to buy your product or service. They don't want to go to the webinar or case study because they don't know who you are yet. And you've made it evidently clear that you just want their money, but you don't care about who they are and if they can truly benefit from your product or service. Sorry, I got a bit passionate. But it's because it happens to me as well. Like, a lot of you guys watching this, you probably have an agency, you're a business owner, you probably get pitches like this all the time. I used to be one of those people. I'm going to hold my hands up. When I first started out on LinkedIn, I was sending those long messages and I really hate myself for it now. But you live and you learn, and I've moved on from those long messages and now I have delightful conversations with people on LinkedIn, which give me way higher conversion than just pitching a high volume of people and hoping for a 3% response rate, because it's not going to get you anywhere. And nowadays on LinkedIn, people are bored and sick of receiving the same thing. So if you want to stand out, you need to genuinely care about this person and come from an angle that isn't selfish. You need to care about them. People like to talk about themselves and their problems. Let them do it and ask them to do it, and you will get a much better response. So don't be salesy is number one. Number two is interact with their content first. Now, I covered my ECCC method in my case study. I'm going to leave the link down below this video in the description box. If you haven't watched the case study, it's free. Go watch it. I outline the strategy that I use to reach out to people. It's my outreach strategy on LinkedIn, which has been original, which has worked for me really well, which I've kept for my paying consulting clients up to this point. And now I've decided to share it with the rest of you. So go and watch the case study video. It's in there. It's free. Take the strategy. Go use it and then let me know the results that you get afterwards. Go watch that, but basically interact with people's content beforehand so you're having multiple points of contact. They're aware of who you are. They kind of know a little bit about you before you're just appearing in their inbox, sliding in their DMs. Interact with their content, and then that's a good leeway for you to then go in and speak to them after you've been complimenting their incredible posts and articles. So interact with people. Number three is be polite. So be nice. Don't be rude. If someone's rude to you, like, I've had people respond and be like, I don't care, or I'm not interested. That's fine. That's not even rude, to be honest. They're just being honest. That's absolutely fine. Not everybody is going to want to listen to you, have a conversation with you, buy your product, buy your service. Some people are just having a bad day and they want to pull someone else down online, and that's absolutely fine. You can try, but I don't care. Like, it's just leave that. Just leave that to the side. If people aren't nice to you, you move on. You find the nice people. You never know what someone's going through at that time of day. So don't get offended and be polite. Just always be polite. There's no reason not to be. And people will just respect you for it. You don't want to have a bad name online. If you're rude to one person, it could be the wrong person that you were rude to, and that could spread and go to other people. So just be polite when you're speaking to everybody. If someone doesn't want to speak to you or they don't want to hear what you do, don't pester them. Just leave them be and just speak to other people. There are millions of users on LinkedIn. I'm sure a lot of them want to speak to you, and a lot of them probably don't, and that's just sales, that's life, and that's how business goes. So be polite. Hey, this is number 4 now. Ask for permission. So this kind of ties in with be polite, but before I send people information on a service or a product or want to kind of take it more down a salesy route, I'll ask them first. So even when I first start speaking to somebody, I'm like, hey, do you mind if I ask you a question? And they're like, yes, of course. And then I'll ask them a question about their business. Afterwards, if I speak about what I do, or if I say, you know what, this is what I do, X, Y, Z. I help people like you. I think it would fit in with your company and helping you achieve this. Would you mind if I sent you a free video audit? Or would you mind if I sent you some more information on how I could help you? Then you let them say yes or no, because I'm not pitched them. I'm asking them if they are open to having that conversation with me. If they're not, that's absolutely fine. If they are, then I can move forwards with that process. So asking for permission, number 4. Number 5, this depends on the type of person that you are, but be funny. So with the right people, like, I'm not saying crack weird jokes with the CEO of Fortune 500 companies. Like, you don't need to be like really funny out there, but with some people that you can read through their profile and you can tell they've got a good sense of humor, I always use that as a way in. So for example, there was a guy who I was going to reach out to on LinkedIn, went to look at his profile before reaching out, and it was literally his about section was speaking about how he hates people pitching him. He's like, if you're thinking about messaging me with a pitch, don't do it. I'm not interested. I don't want to buy your product. Don't want to buy your service. Don't want to watch your free case study. Don't want to go to your webinar. Don't want to do all these things. But if you're going to speak to me, at least send me sushi. This is what it said. So I sent a message. I'll see if I can get the screenshot and put it up here. I sent a message and I was like, hey, name, I've been stewing for months about how I could like reach out and start a conversation with you, and I've come to one conclusion, ... Sent the message. Then I said, do you prefer California or spicy tuna? And like, it's a really awful joke now I say it out loud, but it works and it engages someone in a conversation, because you're making a joke out of something. It's not rude. It's funny. We've got a sense of humor. We started getting into a sales conversation. After that, we speak about what we both did. And then he mentioned like a bad experience he's had with LinkedIn, spending like loads of money on ads. And I was like, oh, I don't personally like to use ads. There's a lot of like cheaper, better ways to get good results. He's like, oh, how's that? And then that's my perfect entry to go in and be like, well, this is how you do it. So if you can be funny, if you have a little spark, sense of humor, you can tell by the joke I just made that it doesn't have to be excellent, but it will work better than just, I see we went to the same university, or, oh, you worked for this company. I worked for them too at one point. Like, that's great, and like, it does work sometimes, but everybody's using that now. It's like, oh, we're in the same industry. So are hundreds of thousands of other people in the marketing industry. It doesn't set you apart. So yeah, that's that are all my points. Got really passionate about this one. I hope this helps. Try and be original. Watch the free case study for the ECCC strategy. I promise you it works. Let me know your thoughts. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one for more LinkedIn content.